social issues. So from that particular point onwards, we are going to start. So the last slide that was related to social issues, and we have just seen the names of social issues. And whatever is the point, from that particular point onwards, we are going to start our session. I hope my voice is clear and audible. Is that clear? Okay. I have shared my screen. Let me know whether it is visible or not. Is it visible? Is it visible or not? Yeah, you don't talk. Yeah.
Visible.
Speak loudly. Is my voice clear?
Yes, sir.
So yes, sir. We were taking the information about social issues and environment, and we guys have just gone through the list of social issues, and that was our slide number 8, if I'm not wrong. So we have seen the names of social issues, and there are a number of issues other than this list also, but we are going to focus on these social issues which are related to environment. And these issues are urban problems related to energy, water conservation, resettlement and rehabilitation issues, environmental ethics, climate change, global warming, acid rain and ozone layer depletion, nuclear accidents and Holocaust, wasteland reclamation, consumerism and waste products. So these are the issues which we are discussing one by one. So starting with the first one, as I told you, there are different social issues which are created because of the excessive use of environment and excessive use of natural resources. For whatever issues we are going through, those are the results of this kind of excessive use of natural resources and the hazards which we have made for the environment. So because of this kind of things which we guys have made with the environment, and certain other reasons are also there for the environmental issues or social issues, those are like, you know, natural calamities and man-made calamities, or man-made events also we can call it. So when it comes to this, other issues are also taken here, like energy demanding activities. There are certain activities which we want to go for energy demanding activities as such. So as far as energy demanding activities are concerned, what sort of things are, or wherever energy is expected, those examples we have taken here. Residential and commercial lighting, where the energy is highly demanded. Private and public transport, where also energy is highly demanded. Modern lifestyle, where electronic gadgets we are using in a massive manner or excessive manner. We all have started using electronic gadgets for different purposes. If you visit any home, we can see n number of electronic gadgets such as fridge, oven, microwave, then washing machine, electronic TV, mobile phones, laptops, tabs. So many electronic gadgets we are using. And for if you want to run all these electronic gadgets, if you want to perform functions with these electronic gadgets, we need to have energy in the form of electricity. Then for industries also, there is a need of electricity or energy, and that is also provided. So, and second last one is waste disposal. If we want to dispose waste which is there from the industries, whether it is manufacturing and non-manufacturing, waste is there. So that sort of matter is also interested, and there is also need of energy. Prevention and control of pollution, and whenever we want to control the prevention and if you sorry control the pollution and whenever we want to prevent control pollution related activities, again it is required. So all these are the sectors, or all these are the activities where energy is in demand, or energy is the most and important aspect. So this is what this particular slide is taking. Now we are going to understand the effects if we go for the energy demanding activities. Then what are the effects? Unequal distribution of energy. If we see, energy is unequally distributed among the urban areas and rural areas. In urban areas, energy is distributed as per their requirement, and there is no load shedding as such. But if you visit rural areas, those who are residing in rural areas, they may understand what sort of problems they are facing. One, the energy, electricity is, I suppose, sometimes it happens, electricity goes and never comes, at least for 10 and 12 hours, especially in night hours. So that is not good. So electricity or energy is distributed unequally, which is not good. Then power cuts and load sheddings. We guys have taken this example. We guys have taken this experience, especially in rural areas. There is a power cut as well as load shedding. People, you know, they face this problem for 10 hours or 12 hours. There is no load shedding as such, or there is no light as such, or there is no electricity as such, which is not good, and that should be resolved. This is the only matter. Then demand energy from other states. Even other states are also buying energy from our state. So if we want to fulfill the demand of other state, then we need to cut something for our state people. So that is the problem. Overall society suffers. So entire society suffers from this particular scarcity of energy. People are facing the problem of scarcity of energy, which is not good at all. Then economic development hampered, and because of there is no energy, most of the time economic development is not taking place, and it has been hampered. We guys have seen that. So this is the fact of demand of energy and all. I hope you guys have understood this. Then now we are going to talk about the social issues which we are coming across. As we know that social issues are coming, and people are facing some problems about certain issues. For example, as we guys have seen that the social issues are there. So those issues we are discussing now. If you look at the first one, what are they and which are they? The first one is water conservation. Water conservation is the most important aspect, because whatever water we get through rain, rain is the only, rain is the major source of water that we get. And but we got failure in conserving the water that we get from the rain. Most of the time what happened, whatever water we get from the rain, that is, disposed, or this is, just vanished to the ocean or into the river. We cannot, cannot conserve that water. There are no proper methods of conservation of water. So because of no water conservation, we face some problems, we face some issues in water conservation. And we guys have seen in certain part of our state, for example, if we take an example of Maharashtra, certain part of the Maharashtra, or in certain or particular states, a particular part of Maharashtra, there is no water to drink for the people. People walk kilometers to get drinking water, and half of the day they waste for getting drinking water. This is the situation. Whereas in certain areas of Maharashtra, there is a full amount of water, and these people, they just waste water. So if you compare, if you see this contradictory situation, if you see this contrary situation, if you see this kind of situation where water is available at large and where water is not available at all. So if you compare these two situations, definitely we should understand the need of water conservation. So water conservation is the issue that we people have to discuss, we people have to go through. And if we are able to conserve the water, then we will not have this kind of issues. And this is what a very good initiative is taken by Pani Foundation, which is led by Amir Khan and Kirendra. So that was very good, and people got benefited. Most of the villages also, they got benefited because of that initiative. So it was a very good initiative, no doubt at all. And from that particular initiative, they are trying to conserve the water. They are trying to, whatever water we get through rainfall, that they are trying to conserve. So here are certain facts about water conservation that I'm going to tell you. Water is a vital resource, no doubt. water is the vital resource of natural resources, and water is the most important aspects that we want every day. And if we do not get a water in a day, what will happen? Just imagine. This is what somebody said, that jal hai to kal hai, pani manje jeevan, asa apan barach vada vakya aikto. So there is a reason behind making this kind of statements. Jal hai to kal hai, it means what? If you have a water, then you have a future. Otherwise, you do not have a future. And you know what will happen? Somebody said like that, in future, if it is world war has happened, that world war will happen because of the water only. And why it is going to be happen? Because people are not taking care of water resources. People are not conserving water resources. And if we do not conserve water resources or water for future generation, definitely there would be a war, and that war would be there for the reason of water only. So this is what water is, a vital resource which is required everywhere. Majority of water resources are polluted heavily. If you want to understand what sort of water resources we have and whether those water resources are polluted or non-polluted, if you want to understand this, you just go through the water resources that you have around, across, or you know, besides you or around you. If we want to take some examples, and if you want to see whether the water resources are polluted or not, if you want to take one example, that is the river Ganga. River Ganga is highly polluted. Most of the pollutants we guys are throwing into River Ganga. And somebody used to say that, I think people used to say that, I think our elders also, we have seen that, they used to say that Ganga, Pavitra Ganga, but now Ganga is also not holy, Pavitra. Ganga is also not Pavitra now, because we guys have dropped some unnecessary material, unnecessary things, even manufacturing water, companies' water, chemical water into Ganga, and now Ganga is not Pavitra, Ganga is not holy. So these water resources, whatever water we get for the purpose of drinking, for the purpose of use in our day-to-day life, that is also not, you know, we cannot say that is not polluted water. It is the polluted water. We need to go for, you know, what we call it, filtered water. We need to go for filtration process, and after filtration we are drinking that water. So why it is polluted? There are so many reasons behind the pollution in water, because we people are responsible for that. Whatever activities we are doing with the water, and those activities are the reasons actually. So here, as I given the example of Ganga, so we can understand how the Ganga is polluted and why Ganga is polluted, and who are the most pollutants or major pollutants to make Ganga polluted. So many things which we guys have discussed, and we are going to discuss. Its amount is limited for use, and when the water is polluted, then there is a limitation for use purpose also. And if we conserve, I think the conservation rate in India is also, you know, very limited. If you look that people, they do not take care of rainfall water. They do not conserve rainfall water. There are no system as such to conserve the water. So that particular activities are limited, and those are not that much flourished. And this is what people are not able to conserve the water. So conservation is extremely important. As I told you, if we conserve the water, then only water will be there for the future generation. Otherwise, we won't have water. If you visit the region like Vidarbha, Marathwada, there is no water as such. People, they just walk kilometers and kilometers to get the water. From the month of January, they started getting water from tankers. So why it is happening? Because they are not conserving the water. Whatever water resources they have, I think basically rain is the main water resource. And if we conserve water, whatever we get from the rain, definitely we will not have these kind of problems. Okay. So what can be done? We have to go for the conservation of water. Whatever a drop of water we are getting on this planet or on this planet Earth, that can be conserved, that can be saved, that can be stored. And this is what new techniques are coming out. Even in cities also, some things or some few concepts, few methods, few techniques are compulsory for housing societies also. They have to go for rainwater harvesting and all. What they are doing? So if you do so, definitely water conservation is possible. So the next point is here. Water conservation refers to reducing the usage of water and recycling of wastewater for different purposes such as cleaning, manufacturing, and agricultural irrigations. So see, the concept of water conservation is not new for you all, because you all are doing this kind of things at home. Even you, if you are from agricultural background, no doubt, then also you are doing such kind of things, and people are trying to conserve the water. How it can be done? So it is a referred to reducing the usage of water and recycling of wastewater for different purposes. Water conservation is what? Water conservation is not a something sort of different concept, which is not possible for we all. It is possible for we all also. It is a very simple concept. Through this particular concept, what we do, we try to reduce the usage of water and we try to recycle the wastewater. See, wastewater means what? The water which is already used. We use some water for bathing purpose in bathroom. We use some water for cleaning purpose in kitchen. So that can be again used. And if we use that water, it is called as recycling of wastewater. Then similarly, water can be used for the industries, and they can, that again it can be used for the another purposes. And usage of water, reducing the usage of water means what? If we want one glass of water for one particular purpose, we can also manage it in half of the glass. Similarly, I think those who are from agriculture, they can understand. Instead of using free water for agricultural crops, we can use drip irrigation, we can go for sprinkler irrigations and so on, and from that we can save water, so we can reduce the usage of water. So there are so many techniques, there are so many things that we can use for the water conservation purpose, and if it is done, definitely it can be called as what? Water conservation. So through water conservation, I'm not giving this message not to use the water. Use water everywhere, wherever it is necessary, but try to reduce the usage of water. At the same time, try to recycle the waste of water, right? So this is expected. And when we go for such kind of activities, it is called as water conservation in a simple manner. Moving on to the next one. That is, what sort of actions are important? What sort of things can be done as far as water conservation is concerned? What sort of actions are important that I'm going to tell you through this particular slide? If you look at the first one, some researchers have suggested that water conservation efforts should be primarily directed at farmers in light of the fact that crop irrigation account for 70% of the world's fresh water use. So see, what this particular action is talking about. This action is talking about water conservation techniques should be suggested. Water conservation techniques should be suggested first of all to all the farmers. As I told you, we use more water than farmers or farming activities for crop purpose. If we have crops like sugar cane, if we have crops like so many things are there, bananas and so on, if we are going for fruits, so if we are using water for crops which we are taking in agricultural field, so there should be a training for the farmers how to conserve the water, how to go for minimum usage of water and maximum output from that particular one. There should be a technique, some technique should be given, some techniques should be suggested to the farmers by conducting certain seminars and workshops. And through that, we have to explain them how water is important and how we can reduce the usage of water. And if you reduce the usage of water, automatically you can improve the irrigation, you can increase the land of irrigation. In getting my point, if we go for drip irrigation, if we go for sprinkler irrigations instead of free water to the crop, definitely you can save some water also. And this is what researchers, those who have done research on usage of water or water conservation, they have suggested that there is a need to give some suggestions, there is a need to give some training to the farmers about usage of water. Because out of 100%, 70% of the water is used in the agricultural field by the farmers. And if we are able to make them aware about the usage of water, definitely half of the work is done or will be done. Now, drip irrigation instead of sprinkler irrigation. See, instead of free water, instead of sprinkler, drip irrigation is the best source of giving water to the crops. And from that, we can save water, we can save reduce the usage of water if we go for drip irrigation. I think you all are aware with drip irrigation because you all are from farmers' family. I think so. Next, common strategies include There are certain strategies which can be used for the purpose of conservation of water, and those I have, you know, taken here. If we want to make farmers aware, if we want to make everybody aware about the usage of water, then these are the common strategies that we can apply, that we can use for the purpose of conservation of water. So what are they? Which are they? Public outreach campaigns. So we need to go into the public, we need to create some campaigns, we need to organize some campaigns for the purpose of water conservation, and that should be for the public. Then tired water rates, charging progressively higher prices as water use increases. So if we use more water, then higher rate should be charged as a charges, and that is called your tired water rates. Tired means what? Step by step water rates can be applied. If we go for lower amount of usage of water, then rate will be different. If you go for middle or medium usage of water, then rate will be different. If you go for higher rates of usage, then water will be different. Okay, so these are the things. Then on restrictions on outdoor water use, such as lawn watering and car washing, on such kind of usage of water, there should be some restrictions. Restrictions should be put on such kind of things, then it will be reduced. Then hundreds of ways to conserve the water. There are a number of ways to conserve the water. And all those ways should be applied, all those ways should be used for the purpose of conservation of water. So this is the thing that I would like to tell you as far as action part of conservation of water. I hope you guys have understood this. Moving on to the next one, and here you can see the some examples of conserving the water or reducing the usage of water. So many things I have, you know, shown here. And from those things, you can understand how the water can be saved. So if you look at the first one, what they have given, water your yard and outdoor plants early or late in the day to reduce evaporation. So suppose you are having a garden, suppose you have a bungalow or you have a bungalow, and in that bungalow you have a garden. So when the plants of your garden should be watered, if you want to reduce evaporation, then your plants which are in your garden should be watered in the morning, early in the morning session or in the evening, because if there is no sun rays, if there is no sunlight, then evaporation rate will be very less. And if you want to go for that, then definitely there is a conservation of water. So n number of examples I have taken here, and accordingly you guys have to apply yourself. If you are not applying yourself so far, start applying this kind of fundas in your day-to-day practice. Definitely you may save some water. Don't feel that we have ample of water, so we don't have any problems of water as such, but try to go for it. It is a need of art. Nowadays you have, but no one can say what will happen after, you know, 10 years, 20 years, or what will happen for your next generation. And if you definitely care for your generation, then you go for it. Otherwise, it will be difficult for your next generation. So these are the fundas, all these are the, you know, techniques, and by using these techniques, you may definitely save some water. You may reduce some usage of water in your day-to-day activities also. So this is for water conservation. Then here is something to show you. The new way conservation. You can conserve water like this. If you look at this picture, you can understand everything in a very, very, very nice manner. So this one is just a picture of bungalow and certain things. So what they have given, and you can see the cloud at the top. Harvest rainwater from roof. Whatever water we get from the rainfall, from our roof, that can be stored somewhere. And this particular process of storing water that we get from the rainfall is called a rainwater harvesting, that we harvest by making one particular septic tank. Here you can see septic tank. Can you see that? Okay, So by doing all those things, we can definitely store some water, we can conserve some water for next generation, and we won't have water problem as such in future generation. If we take such kind of measures, if we take such kind of steps to do that. I hope you guys have understood what I mean to say. Now we are talking about the next concept, that is rainwater harvesting. As I told you, this concept is not new. I think in most of the big housing societies, this particular rainwater harvesting is implemented. They are taking care of rainwater. Whatever rainwater we get, that can be harvested, that can be stored, that can be recycled, that can be reused for different purposes. Suppose if there is a scheme of 150 flats, for example, housing society. So whatever rainwater they get from their roofs, from their garden, that can be harvested somewhere, that can be stored somewhere. Harvesting means what? How this particular rainwater harvesting is processing? How it is taking place? So whatever water we get from the roof, that can be stored in one different and big tank, and that water can be utilized for usage purpose in the society. So by doing this, we save some water, we reduce the usage of water, and when this kind of reduce of usage of water is taken place by using the rainwater, it is called as rainwater harvesting. So now we are going to talk about something different one. So how it can be done? Society, it can be done with different aspects also. So how it can be done, and how that the process of rainwater harvesting is done, that I'm going to tell you through this particular slide. Just look at this. In urban areas, the construction of houses, footpaths and roads has left little exposed earth for water to soak in. If you take an example of urban areas, if you look at the roads, certain footpaths are created. If you look at their houses, certain roofs and small amount of space is also there. So whatever water that we can see on the road in rainy season, whatever water we can see in the society or housing society in the rainy season, that can be stored. How it can be stored? It can be stored by making some tanks in those particular societies or behind opposite the road of those particular cities. So whatever water we get through rain in rainy season, that can be stored in the storage tank created in the society, and that can be recycled whenever we want in that particular society. So this way it will be done. In parts of the rural areas of India, flood water quickly flows to the rivers, which then dry up soon after the rain stops. If this water can be held back, it can seep into the ground and recharge the ground water supply. See what happens, what we guys have seen, I think, गावाकडे आपण बघतो ज्यावेळेस पाऊस पडतो त्यावेळेस सगळं पाणी हे जे ओढ्याला किंवा नदीला किंवा नाल्याला पूर येऊन निघून जातं. 2 दिवस फक्त आपण चिखल वगैरे असतो, पाणी दिसतं आपल्याला, 2 दिवसानंतर सगळं ते सुकून जातं. नंतर आहे तर सिच्युएशन होते. जर हेच पाणी आपण योग्य त्या ठिकाणी अडवलं, योग्य ठिकाणी त्याची आपण सोय केली, योग्य त्या ठिकाणी त्याचा पुरवठा केला, बांध घालून ते आपण स्टोरेज केलं, तर हे वॉटर आपण बरेच दिवस आपल्या शेतीच्या कामासाठी जर वापरू शकतो. बट वी डोंट डू दिस, वी डू नॉट कन्झर्व द वॉटर, वी जस्ट neglect, we just ignore that. And if you stop ignoring that, automatically that water can be used. And if we do so, definitely we can this activity can be helpful to increase the groundwater supply, increase the groundwater level. And this is what this kind of conservation is the most important aspect. This has become a very popular method of conserving water, especially in urban areas. Rainwater harvesting is more popular in the urban areas, because in urban areas there is no chance to leave that water. So if you have a big society, for example, you have seen big housing societies like Madrapatna city, Nanded city, those societies are located or scattered in acres and acres. I think more than 100 acres or 200 acres, the societies are spread. So if we collect the water from those 200 acres and 100 acres, and if we save that water in one particular tank, what will happen? We can utilize that water for future use. This is what this kind of rainwater harvesting system is very much popular, and people are very much serious, by the way. All are educated, so they know that the use of water and the importance of water for future generation. This is what this kind of activity, which is called as rainwater harvesting, is very much important and very much popular among the people of urban areas. Then, rainwater harvesting essentially means collecting rainwater on the roofs of building and storing it underground for later use. Whatever I told you, this is the only thing that I have noted down here. Not only does this recharging arrest underground depletion, it also rises the decline water table and can help augment water supply. So this is the thing that I would like to tell you here. So this is the fact: if we collect the water, if we store the water, if you, you know, store the water in a particular tank, which is which we have received, which we have got from rain in rainy season, and if we store somewhere and if we use that water later, then it will be definitely helpful to increase the water level in groundwater also. So this is what it is more popular. It is more highly used technique as far as the water storage and water conservation is concerned. Status, if you look at the status, what sort of status we have in our country as far as rainwater harvesting is concerned. Town planners and civic authority in many cities in India are making rainwater harvesting compulsory in all new structures. Nowadays, government is also very much, you know, serious, and government is also making certain rules. Nowadays, if you want to construct a house in city like Mumbai, Pune, it is mandatory for you all to go for water harvesting or rainwater harvesting compulsorily. Even for new housing schemes, and it is necessary for all the new housing schemes to go for rainwater harvesting. Even they have to go for solar energy also. So by making certain laws, government is also planning to make it compulsory for all the society members or all the new construction or construction firms or construction builders to make it compulsory. Or they have made it compulsory, otherwise they don't issue us a permission to construct. No water or sewage connection would be given if new building did not have provisions for rainwater harvesting. When it comes to giving a new water connection or sewage connection to the new buildings, so those are not given without having this provision of rainwater harvesting, I think so. Next one, a number of government buildings have been asked to go in for water harvesting in Delhi and other cities of India. If you take an example of Delhi and other cities of India, the government has asked them to go for water harvesting. Otherwise, they will not permit you to construct the house as a building. So this is the status. And actually, I would like to tell you, these are the very good steps which are taken by the government as far as rainwater harvesting is concerned. But this is my observation. Most of the urban area people, they are serious about rainwater harvesting. But if we visit rural areas, these guys are the people those who are residing in rural areas. They are not that much serious about rainwater harvesting. They do not take care of rainwater harvesting. They neglect, they ignore this particular part of rainwater harvesting, which is not good. It should be simultaneously worked in urban areas as well as rural areas, then it will be, you know, practically possible, otherwise not possible. And it is the right time to wake up and think about the concept of rainwater harvesting, which is very good sign of everything. So if you look at this, how the rainwater can be collected. So this one is an example, and this one is a diagrammic example, and from that you can understand how the process of rainwater harvesting is taken place. And from this, you can also understand the exact process of rainwater harvesting. See, the clouds are there, then rain is started, water is started falling down, and the water is collected through the pipe from the roof. and the collected water is stored in the tank, which is called about a rainwater harvesting tank. Here is this tank, and after that, the same water can be reutilized or recycled after few days for different purposes. And if we do so, it can be called as rainwater harvesting and rainwater recycling also. I hope you guys have understood whatever I'm teaching. So this one is another aspect, that is watershed management, and that we are going to take in tomorrow's session, not in today's session. Almost we have only 2 minutes to go. So I will start with this concept in tomorrow's session. Just remember this, and whenever I will ask you tomorrow where we stopped, please tell me. So this is my presentation for a day. I'm going to wind up here, but definitely we are going to meet with this particular point, watershed management, in tomorrow's session. Till then, thank you. I'll get back to the home screen by stopping my presentation. Hello guys, I hope you guys have understood whatever I taught you. And I request you all to ask your questions if you have. If you do not have any questions, then we don't have any problem as such to wind up the session. So I request you all to turn on your camera so that I can see you. Please turn on your camera. Everybody.